Hello, everybody. Today, we are going to take a look at the PC Engine / TurboGrafx-16 core on the Analogue Pocket. And there is some interesting things to dive into. I'm curious how well it does with audio and graphics, and also some of the different controllers that work on it. I will tell you right up front that I do approach this a little bit from the speedrunner perspective. I speedrun a lot of games on the TurboGrafx-16. So just know that that's where my, what's the lag like? What's it like when it, does it feel like it does on the actual console? So let's dive in. So first, let's talk about some different types of controllers that work on the Analogue Pocket. And there is a limited support as of right now, but they do add more controllers with some firmware updates and things like that. I originally tried out the TurboGrafx-16 mini controllers, and those have a USB. And these have worked great for me on stuff like the Mister. I've had no problem with it on the Mister. Unfortunately, the Analogue Pocket dock only supports controllers right now with DirectX support. So as far as I know, there isn't a mode where we can change the Mini into a DirectX mode, so it did not work. So the controllers I've mainly been using on it are the 8-bit Duo Pro 2, and that worked fine wired and wirelessly. Excuse me, I was able to get both of those. The SN30, and this is just the one that kind of looks like a Super Nintendo controller, and it worked just fine wirelessly right out of the box. Didn't have to click anything else. Also works with a USB cable. And then the one I'm going to be testing out mostly today is this. This is the 8-bit Duo PCE controller. And when I first plugged it into the console, it's got a little dongle that works over the 2.4 gigahertz spectrum. And it paired, but I couldn't get it to work on the dock itself. And it turns out this thing does have a DirectX support mode. So when you load up your Analogue Pocket, this is the screen you get. And if you haven't yet, I'm gonna walk through the process of actually installing all of the open FPGA cores. That's how you play different systems and different consoles on the Pocket, and also how you get ROM files that you've legally acquired, and you can get those on the Pocket as well. So if this is your first time installing the cores for the Analogue Pocket onto an SD card, honestly, the process is really straightforward. Just go over to the link in the description, or you can literally just Google Pocket Updater, and it's the first link that pops up. You'll see here, I searched for it, and here it is on the top link. You just click over to it, and you get Matt Pinella's GitHub here. And sometimes if you've never navigated a GitHub, it could be a little bit overwhelming. Thankfully, this one makes it pretty easy. Just scroll down to where it says instructions, and just download this latest release here. And we're gonna do the Windows one. Click on the link. It should download for you. I'm gonna put it in my downloads folder. And then all you gotta do is drag the zip file over to the Pocket. Now I've already installed this one, so it's gonna override mine, but yours will be the first time, and just unzip here. So extract all, depending on what zip program you're using. And I'm actually gonna place them in my SD card. So select the right folder, select folder. It may ask me to overwrite. Yes, replace the files in this destination. It's gonna do its thing. And then while the card is still installed, go ahead and run the executable file that just unzipped. And it says Pocket Updater Zip. So from here, I'm gonna delete the old zip file because I don't need that anymore, and run the Pocket Updater. And it does its thing. And what it's doing is it's putting on all of whatever available cores are currently out right now. And the list is on the GitHub. Oh, gotta press enter to continue. It's update all. You can also update your firmware and all the if on the Pocket. And in fact, a lot of times this installer won't work without the latest firmware. So we'll do an update all. Hit enter. It's doing its thing. And if you want to see a list of what cores are being installed while it's doing its thing, if you went back to the GitHub, click on back, and it has all of your latest cores. A complete list of available cores can also be found here. So click on there, you will see what cores are currently on the updater. And this is getting updated all the time. So for all of the ROM files, I use the assets folder here, and you have your different consoles. So let's say NES, you go into the NES folder, and you'll see that there is a common folder. You just double click on the common, and this is where I placed all of my NES ROMs. You are good to go. You can pop the SD card out and throw it in the Analogue Pocket. And let's take a look at some of the menu settings before we get started. Ew, bunk. Yes. So there are some... I did set some of these ahead of time. So the controls. So other core settings. We have load cartridge. We can reset the core. Use the turbo tap, which is cool. You could actually play multiple controllers. I don't remember exactly how many it supports, but it supports multiple. You can use the six-button controller, which... This only has four buttons. Don't know how you do it. But if we were using the 8-Bit Do Pro 2, probably could use the six button. Maybe just try out Street Fighter, actually. That's probably not a bad idea. Maybe I'll switch over controllers. Oh, this is cool, too. So you can set one of your buttons to a turbo button. And that's awesome. So like if using the 8-Bit Do Pro 2, you can actually just map one of your buttons up here to turbo. So you could run it just like this little controller does. Extra sprites. I have no idea what the hell that is. What do you think that did? I don't know what that does. Raw RGB color. Let's take a look at the difference there. Does it look any different? I'm not seeing a difference there either. Might have to see. Wait for the editing to see that. Oh, cool. Okay. That's kind of a nice. So you believe it ups the sprite limits to stop sprite flickering. That's pretty cool. The master audio boost, we're going to try this out on Alice because Alice is very soft. And then you can restart all the default. Very cool. This is Alice in Wonderdream, and this game very much has a much softer sound. Okay, so I haven't changed the volume levels of any of the recording at all, so you can already hear it's much softer. We'll try the audio boost. Okay, so let's try out audio boost. Oh, wow. That was almost too much. Okay, well, did not ladder very well there, so let's... So I have been playing this game recently as I was prepping for a marathon a few weeks ago. Okay, it seems to be, probably because of the wireless controller, that's what I'm guessing, but there seems to be just a slight delay in the input. Maybe like, you know, I don't know. Let's see here. Maybe not. Let's try out Ninja Spirit. Been a while since I played this game. Let's give it a try. Now, you don't need to play this game with Turbo, interestingly enough. I'm almost sure it wasn't Turbo in the arcade. It's a port of an arcade game, so. There is lag, though. Oh, interesting. Turbo's working slightly different. I remember you've used... Noticing some slight glitches again in the screen. Those things will... Some enemies will one-hit kill you. That's what it was in this game. That hurt. So normally, I think you do a whole thing. It's really fun. It's not a very long playthrough, Epic. Even my first playthrough, I got through pretty quick. These grenades are pretty overpowering. Well, there you go. As you can see, tough first boss fight. So really enjoying the PC Engine core on the Analogue Pocket, and a lot of great things already in here. The fact that there's support for Turbo, even though you may not have a Turbo controller, is fantastic. Changing the audio levels with the boosting, because so many games are at different audio levels, is awesome. Just having those options is fantastic. And being able to map it the way that you want to, I thought it was really great, really easy to switch between games and things like that. So really like that aspect to it. At some point, would love if it's possible to see save states, but I know that save states on TurboGrafx-16 and PC Engine is challenging in and of itself. And in fact, on actual hardware, we haven't even received yet. This is February of 2023. We don't have a flash cart or flash card of any sort that can support save states at this current point. But Crix has announced that coming up, his new PC Engine EverDrive is going to have save state support. So maybe that'll filter down. Even on the Mister, we don't have save states yet either. And speaking of that, I want to give a huge shout out to the developer of this. Adam Gastineau is the person who's ported this over to the Analogue Pocket. It's a port of the Mister PC Engine core, and it's running great. It's really fun, really enjoyable. Great to have it on the go. That's one of the nice things about the Analogue Pocket. So all in all, great stuff. Controller support, of course, obviously would be nice to have more controller support in the future. And in fact, if it's possible, I don't know if the Analogue Pocket dock is capable of it, but being able to support the TurboGrafx-16 mini controller, I think would be really nice. I also tried it with an adapter, a USB adapter for a PC Engine controller, and obviously because it's not DirectX compatible, didn't support it. But if it can support some sort of native USB protocols, I don't exactly know how they work because this is not my area, but if that's something that can be contributed to, that would be pretty awesome as well. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to check this out. But the updater, if you're using the Analogue Pocket, and that's just that updater is the way to make sure you get everything on there, and it's updated all the time, literally every day. There seems like there's something new on it. So, and feel free to support any of those developers and creators that are doing all this work, quite a bit, and pretty awesome to see some of this kind of stuff and see how it works out. So, for me, overall thumbs up. Definitely give it a try if you have an Analogue Pocket, and hope you enjoy.